Les ODD fournissent le cadre.
The SDGs provide a framework for discussions and cooperation multilaterally. They were negotiated and they are driven by the UN. And this immediately creates a paradox. This multilateral framework, as it stands today, is not necessarily the best forum to achieve these goals. The SDGs suffer from what political scientists call the Westphalian paradox, a reference to the Treaty of Westphalia, which in the 17th century ended one of the longest conflicts in Europe, the 30-year war, and which bases international order on respect by parties for the sovereignty of states. But they are based on the goodwill of governments, which can change to be implemented. So it's very clear to anyone reads the paper or watches the news that there have been changes recently in the multilateral framework that mean that if one were to renegotiate the SDGs today, it would fail, or at least the compromise would not be as advanced as what was actually achieved, which is why they are priceless. We need to hang on to the reference framework for it to continue to be transformative, although what I've just said means that it is not only on the level of the public authorities that the SDGs can be achieved, because the financial mass of investment required is not or no longer available to nation states in a context of reducing public spending, public debt, and therefore other sources of funding need to be found, notably in civil society, in the private sector, in social economy. But the role of governments does nevertheless remain very important. It's very important for that role to not be restricted to use an expression that is very trendy at the UN, since we've talked about the SDG, that it mustn't turn into a beauty contest where every government every year would come along and say that they have followed 167 of 169 targets, and that for the greatest majority of them they have accomplished significant advances. No, the action of governments must not be an action of propaganda, but a true action of transformation, and the SDGs need to be increasingly placed at the heart of public policies. And one can only hope, and we will see if it is the case with the European Union in the years to come, one must only hope that the public policies will integrate all of these SDGs and also get rid of, for instance, subsidies for fossil fuels or certain ways, so the unsavory ways of managing migration of populations, to lighten the burden and foster integration policies that move in the right direction. The limitations and the essential role of governmental action, of public policies, clearly appears if it is understood that one of the essential levels of implementation of the SDGs is that of the territories. So, of course, the spatial limitations and configurations of these territories must be defined from one country to another, one region to another, or the institutional, political organization or cultural traditions. And once this has been established, it is truly within communities and territories that the most immediate operation of these SDGs can occur, and the role of public policy is essential. essential in facilitating the implementation of the SDGs and also removing any blocks that may restrict them. If there's a systematic policy of subsidizing fossil fuels, for instance, that hinders the possibility of energy transition towards renewables, if tax policies restrict redistribution of wealth towards the poorest populations, it'll be difficult to solve with a silver bullet the question of inequalities within social groups and so on. But at the same time, the level of the territory of the community involves all of the stakeholders of society, of the economy, all of the political and cultural stakeholders, alongside the authorities, and helps to manage the contradictions or conflicts that may arise, conflicts with vested interests that are unfavorable to sustainable development and would like to preserve the status quo in production and consumption that are clearly a potential disaster for the planet.